previously on Darkness Over Daggerford.
Well met.
Look, get out of here. Yeah? Now look. The mayor here is on the verge of calling to Waterdeep for protection. Be easy if you just move on now. Whoa. Last thing we need is Waterdeep and army crawling over our business. Come on, Layot. We're moving out. Yes, you are. It is ours.
Hey there. Lovely place you have here. A spot of daubing, a few new carpets and draperies, and clear out a few boulders. You could have yourself a really cozy bolt hole.
Astriel, what the... How in the hell did you get in here? Come.
Hello again. How did you get on with Mayor Vinci?
Yes, Mayor Wisely is happy and has given me the temple's keys, Havasir. Let's talk about your disappearing animals now.
Wonderful news indeed. So, as I said, I have sent word to the shepherds to the west, and they expect your presence any day now.
Hello? Dalaran, please help me. The young elf maiden at your door might have once been pretty, but now her face is swollen red, distorted by hundreds of tiny red scars. She moans with pain, staggers unsteadily, holding her empty hands out toward you. Okay, let's go ahead and meet those shepherds.
Understand why the shepherds bring their herds here. It may be a dangerous wilderness, but it is lush indeed.
Indeed. What is it, laddies? Do you smell something, boy? What? Jumping jackrabbit! Did you see that? No ordinary.
Greetings.
I heard of this happening to other folks, but I never thought it happened to a poor man like me. Aw, shucks. And old Betty was my favorite cow. Did you hear something that sounded like a giggling before Betty vanished? No. I heard nothing except old Laddie barking. Settle down there, boy. Betty's gone. There ain't nothing we can do about it. Why don't you have Laddie sniff out the trail? Trail? Looks to me like poor Betty just went poof. So why would there be a trail anyhow? Old Laddie never could smell too well on account of his frightful allergies, you know. Okay.
Greetings.
Poor Betty. Ah, I heard you. Oh, oh! You little devil. Goblin rustler. I can see you, you thieving little goblin. Die, you little fool.
There.
You'll feel the power of this. That little sneak walked off. What in the nine hells of Noosa? And me tired as all get out. Why the nine hells? I'll drain you with a negative spell. I'll drain you with a negative spell. In there, everyone. Let's get out of here. Oh, by the nine hells. We need to escape.
For gold and gold.
By the nine hells, that was dangerous. Damn near died there. Thank goodness I found it. We gotta find a way to escape. Okay. go back. By the nine hells of Nissus. Find the nine hells of Nissus!
Ortano, for Digyama!
Die by the nine hells of Nissus! I need to stop that priest there. He's cast some sort of negative spell on me. Why the nine hells of Nissus? Who the hell is that?
Ortano,
got him! By the nine hells of Nissus! Get him! Get in there! Find the nine hells of Nissus! Lay him down! Cursed mage. Use a spell of cursing. These skeleton bones will be used for my potions. Curses. This is truly a treacherous area. Okay. We'll need the rest. Oh no. No resting here. By the nine hells of Nissus. Need to see if we can rest. Where that shepherd is. Our escape. Yes. I thought we might be able to rest here by the shepherds. Fantastic. See if we can pick up the trail of that stinking cattle rustler. made of a lure that's... By all the cursed gods. Baal included. I saw a place further off in the distance. He may have taken the cows there. By all the cursed gods. Yes, I believe we can find him here.
Ah, the salty sea air. We gnomes prefer the earthy sense of underground, but Granda Retsartnerd had this idea for a submerging burrow to travel the high seas. It, well, it sunk.
Well, nothing ventured, nothing gained.
A siege! These knights look downcast, however. I doubt they are faring well.
Interesting. Let's see what the story is here.
Well met.
Hello. You should speak with Sir Griswold in his tent. Very well. This is peculiar. Not what I expected.
What do you want?
Our soldiers and I lay siege to Castle Excellence. We have no need of your help. Goodbye. Well, you have
Hello.
Something good. Sir Griswold is a noble man. What do you want? Fine. Let's not act too hasty here. First things first, let's go see if we can catch down that cattle rustler. Obviously, they didn't bring the cattle this way. And hope we don't run into something along the way. You made camp during your journey 6 hours. Great.
Thank you.
well.
Seen anything else?
Greetings.
Poor Betty. Betty might be gone forever. There's an ox over here. Oh, hold on a second. There's more cows over here. What the? Don't let your bros.
I seem to have stepped in something. Yeah, my boots. Cursed cows.
Talk to the shepherd. Oh, damn it, cow. Shut up.
Good tidings to ya.
Young shepherdess grins cheerfully as she waves, although her face is plain. You know anything about the missing cows? I'm certain that the dreaded one-eyed warg is to blame. None of the other farmers agree with me. But they know nothing. I've seen old one-eye. He's nasty and a big old hog. Wait, too much sour cheese. Young shepherd girl quickly knuckles her wide forehead and spits twice over her shoulder, ward off against bad luck. That doesn't make any sense. Wargs hunt at night, and animals vanish during the day. Old One-Eye is no ordinary warg. He's twice the size of any ordinary warg. He's tricky as a hungry fox. Where's this warg? I'll kill it. Last night I saw old One-Eye looking at the edge of the South Woods. When you kill it, bring me its head as proof of your deed. Young shepherdess points towards the southeast where a large stand of tall oaks grow. Ominous shadows, thick as black tar, cling to the dark spaces. Excuse me. Okay. With this guy.
Hello.
Knight. Jarek's the name. Well met, Jarek. I'm evil or Nastra's foe. Have her sent me to help you. So one of them would have someone come and help us. Alright, tell me what's been happening to your animals besides disappearing. The damnedest thing. Whatever's happened, it ain't beasts, that's for sure. Yeah, I know, it's goblins. I see you be no country lad, I. Our animals have just disappeared. In there, no bones, No blood, no skin, nothing. Definitely isn't the wild beasts that run around here. Listen, these eyes have watched over 1,000 cattle, to now I've lost less than 12. And then to ferocious giant bears, and one time a passing rock. It's not possible to just walk up and steal one. There'd be something strange at work. Okay, so what can you tell me about the past around here? This be a hard land. Hard as you like. Look around us. This be the best grass to be found on the Sword Coast, my friend. And yet, it doesn't come without its price. Wild beasts and worse roam the hills and valleys. And the troll bar... Forest lies away to the south. Lane tells you all you need to know. She's a foolish shepherd that grazes too close to those woods. There be caves cut out by running water, but don't dare tempt fate by being nosy around them. You watch yourself if you begin a fancy go exploring underground, I will. Do you think there could be something living in the caves that could be taking shepherds and their animals? Maybe. But I sure never seen anything but wild beasts and the old troll driven. Driven from the forest by hunger or something foul. I've walked these hills for 20 years or more. Is that your hut? All the shepherds out here use these huts for shelter in times of... Doesn't belong to me or anyone. Okay, that's enough for now. Let me see what I can discover. May Saloon watch over you then. Okay, well, call me suspicious. See what's going on in here. Basic stone floor hut offering the bare minimum. I guess I can't go in there. Why do you have that door closed? What are you doing, little young?
Hi there.
Wow, an adventurer. Jerick's son looks about purity. I talked to my dad. You don't want to know what's going on. So, what the hell is that?
Ortano for Digyama.
Hit you with this negative beam. see what this will do. You'll love this. Come on! What are you guys waiting for? Are you guys waiting for some sort of invitation? Kill this thing! Be it dead? I hit it with that negative beam. Took its head. He'd be dead now. Let's go get our money. Nom nom.
The toy thing's to ya.
Yeah, here's its head. It's dead. So that's old one eye, huh? Well, won't be killing more of my cows. Okay. I'd like a reward for killing him. Please, Ivar, take this simple shepherd's charm and help me see what might be hidden in the darkness. Nom offers you a small husk of broken glass. Tied to a stubby wooden handle. Alright. Thanks, Charm. Goodbye, Eli. Watch your step, because wargs aren't the only danger in these pastures. Kind of pointing to the cow dung. Well. See what she actually gave us. I really need to find a magical shop that can actually identify some of this stuff. Did she just give us some visibility? Wow. Will be useful. Thank you. Thank you very much, Ivana. Okay, so let's continue the journey. That stinking goblin will come out here at night. 7 during the day. Got to be something I'm missing here. Tell you what. We'll rest up a few hours. See if things change at night. It's 4 o'clock. Travel a little bit. O'clock in the morning. Not long after I witnessed the cow seemingly vanish into thin air, accompanied by a cackling laughter. Someone or something. Seems like they have magical help in their crying. Where's that rod at? I don't remember selling it. Maybe here? What in the hells is that? Troll shaman! By the gods! In the nine places of shamans! We got trolls!
Ortano, for Tigyama!
What the? What? Why nine places of hell?
Ortano, for Tigyama!
Why the nine places of hell? Die!
Ortano, for Tigyama!
By the nine places of hell! Ortano, for Digimon!
Ortano, for Digimon!
Ha! By the nine places of hell! Die! What a nine places of hell! He's trying to knock my head off! I have nine places of hell! Die!
Taste steel, villainous wretch!
Nine places of hell! Thank you. What can we do? Hit him with that negative energy. It didn't do anything. He must have got the dead spell. He put a dead man spell on me. Damn you all by the hells! Damn you by the cursed hells! We're dead. Damn you. And you, the plains of Nessa. Curses. Damn that thing by the plains. Oh, it was all a bad dream.
Greetings.
Tidings, citizen. You stand in the presence of Belshire, Master, the Sufferer. Theosopher? Is there anything like a philosopher?
No.
Oh no, dear child. But there are Sufferer, nothing like a philosopher. Philosopher theorizes based on logic and empiricism, whereas a theosopher relies entirely on deductive reasoning, intuition. Deductive reasoning and intuition does sound counterintuitive to me. It would somewhat unskilled in modern rhetorical theory. You see, the theosophers use our deductive skills to validate naturally held principles.
It's
So you use deductive reasoning to enforce your pre-existing beliefs. Precisely. Take, for example, the encampment to our north. One sees a brightly colored tent with youthful men and women performing drills and calisthenics. It is quite obviously a traveling circus. It's like a cast of seeds to me. Well, perhaps so, but that's beside the point. You see, my gut reaction is to look upon the scene and proclaim that is a traveling circus. My next step involves proving it so by deductive reasoning. So what if your deductive reasoning leads you to make a different assumption or conclusion? It can. That's the beauty of Durosophy. Your first instinctual cognition is always the right one. You simply use deductive reasoning to prove this hypothesis. As Master Vogel would say, intuition trumps empiricism. Master Vogel, you see, was the first of us progenitors, the first wise man atop the cliff. But he is lost to us now, so I've taken up his mantle as leader of our order.
No!
Don't listen to this nonsense. I am the anointed wise man atop the cliff, as chosen by Master Vogel himself. Oh, really? And just when this succession ceremony take place, pray tell, on Vogel's deathbed?
Don't speak of Master Sol Vogel, who was the greatest mind of our age, a true visionary.
What happened to your master?
He left us.
The master was filled with despair, and he leapt from these very cliffs to his death. A child standing nearby claimed his last word, "The recipe is for the birds." We now know he is speaking in metaphors. Master loved feeding the gulls that congregate on these cliffs. We believe his study of these birds led him to some deeper meaning.
Yes.
Yes, we believe it has something to do with how birds ride the wind.
We believe our master hoped his own belief system will help him ride aloft the winds and take flight, metaphorically and otherwise. If successful, it would prove once and for all that intuition trumps empiricism, and thus establishing the prophecy as a cornerstone of future studies in rhetorical theory. Very soon, I shall follow the master's example and take the plunge.
Charlatan,
Montebach, it is I, Zanaga, who shall follow our master's example and leap from the sacred cliffs. Well, I think you should both jump. Interesting. So the survivor would obtain the mantle as new leader of order, a wise proposition. Yes, a capital idea. Let's put our dear Rastafarizing to the test. And now I'm the master of the Rastafarizing. I tricked them. Okay, well, looks like we may have come to our place of conquest. And perhaps this is where our cattle have gone. An ochre jelly!
You shall find a quick death!
multiplying!
Hold on, everyone.
No, hell is that noise? More ogre jellies.
Wait one, my friends. I have a fireball for you.
Taste steel, villainous wretch!
Whatever gods you worship.
Die! Pray, whatever god you worship.
Taste steel, villainous wretch.
Pray, whatever god you worship. Pray, whatever god you worship. Pray! Oh, God.
You better have some coin on you after all this trouble.
You shall find a quick death.
Pray! Whoever gods you worship. Whoever gods you
worship. Say hello to my crossbow.
Great prize!
Pray, whoever gods you worship. Pray to whatever gods you worship. Pray to whatever gods you worship. Pray to whatever gods you worship.
Ortano, for Digyama.
Pray to whatever gods you worship.
Taste steel, villainous wretch.
Pray to whatever gods you worship.
Taste steel, villainous wretch!
Pray to whatever gods you worship. Pray, whatever gods you worship.
Ortano, for Digyama.
That did you.
What a mess. We'll need to rest up now. Oh, pray to whatever god they're back. To whatever god you worship. Oh no. Our rest was interrupted. Pray to whatever gods you worship. Run!
Yeah, taste steel, villainous wretch.
They're everywhere! Ah, no! Run! Wait! God, you
to my crossbow.
God, you worship. I can't get through. Whatever gods I worship.
No, no. Great prize.
Whatever gods I worship. I was dissolved. Sorry, I got it dissolved. What a disaster. Let's see if they're in here.
You'd better have some coin on you after all this trouble.
Ortano, Digama!
What happened? That did it. Yeah, that's the only thing they understand. It's fire.
You shall find a quick.
Sorry about this, guys. This is the only thing they understand.
For honor and duty!
Okay.
Pray to whatever gods you worship. What other foul beasts are in here?
For gold and, gold.
Ortano, for Digama.
You bet.
Ortano, for Digama.
Sorry about this. What happened?
Ortano, for Digimon.
That did him. One more good fireball to do it.
Ortano, for Digama.
You shall find a quick death.
Oh boy. Oh crap. Let's go, guys. We are leaving. We are leaving. We are like leaving now.
It shall be.
Yeah, that can be any. There's no cattle in here. Let's go. We are leaving. This is us leaving. Woo. Yeah. Okay. More fire. Let me take the lead. No. Stand your ground.
Ortano, for Digama.
Right. Shall we? I can do that.
Oh. Did I set myself on fire? Come on, cast it.
Ortano, for Digama.
They must have dissolved all the treasure. There's nothing in there. Okay, let us go. Well, I do apologize. There's nothing in here, but stinking, acidic, poisonous Oh
my god.
No. Oh, no. Just follow. We are leaving.
It shall be.
Ah! Woo! By the stars, we... We're just going to talk to this person, whoever he is, and we're getting back on task before we run into something even crazier. Have you seen any cattle here? Wohog, his long stringy hair is matted with dirt and dead leaves. The strange man waves a friendly greeting at you. Who are you? Me? Wohog. He points to his emaciated chest, smiles a toothless grin. Gets any food? Wohog vigorously scratches his hairy armpits, questing for hidden lice. Oh god, it finds one pops in his mouth. Filthy creature. The old hermit yelps in fear. You filthy monster!
For gold and gold.
What type of filthy beast are you?
Die now!
Your end draws nigh.
Wohog. Filthy monster. Had a little gold on it. What else he was... Do I have food? Filthy monster.
Behold the Sea of Swords, home to seafaring merchants, smugglers, and pirates. Although I doubt anyone would drop anchor among these rocky cliffs.
Yeah. That's bad. I don't want to attack that. Okay. Sea of Swords. We don't run into those hill giants. Oh, thank goodness. Okay. I do not know what to do about this. We should have magical help. Maybe I'll have to admit failure. I have not discovered him since he left. Well, I don't know. Well, let's put a pause in this because I don't know where these cattle are gone. Never walk through a path barefoot. Well, I'm not barefoot. Let me talk to this guy again.
Hello.
got a question for you. Nothing happening. Again. Discovered anything. Okay. We'll be back.